second part of this presentation, and because we have not finished to define yet how Plexus input exactly works. As was said in the beginning, we have five modes. Now, Stefanos just touched the first three modes of input. And now I will discuss the other two modes of Plexus input, and I will also talk a little bit on the output program. So, so this is the program structure again. We have Plexus input, we have Plexus output. Now the gray part, the first line definition of the problem, is the part that Stefanos just did. Now it looks like he only did very little, but that is of course not true. I mean, he discussed the main part of Plexus input, and I will just do the remaining part. So again, we have the overview of the modes here. So the soil and structures mode and the mesh mode were just discussed, and we will now talk about the flow conditions mode and the stage construction mode. So let's start with the flow conditions mode. In the flow conditions mode, we can specify all the things that are related to, as the name already says, flow. This can be water flow. This can also be thermal flow. Now, the thermal flow part we will completely leave out of this these four sessions. Maybe at some point we're going to do some additional online training on that, but we just focus on water since the vast majority of Plexus users regularly needs to define water flow in their soil, but not so many actually need to define the thermal flow. So we just focus here on the water part of the flow conditions mode. Now, what kind of water levels do we have? Well, we first have to distinguish, and that is purely a naming thing, in borehole water levels as well as user water levels. What is the difference between the two? Well, when we define the borehole, we could already specify a head value. We could per layer actually specify whether in that layer we want to have a different piezometric level, for instance, because we have a sand layer that is caught in between two clay layers, and the sand layer is connected to a lake somewhere in the mountains, and therefore the sand layer is an aquifer, it has a different water level. We can specify that in the borehole. Now, as soon as we move to the flow conditions mode, then Plexus actually interprets that data from the different layers in the borehole into water levels. So it will generate a water level that represents the head. It may generate water levels that represents the different piezometric levels of the different layers and assigns them. And all those levels just get the name borehole water level, so that you know that those water levels that occur in the flow conditions mode are actually generated by Plexus based on your borehole information. Now, on top of that, we can also define our own water levels. For instance, you want to make an excavation, and in the excavation, you want to lower the water level. That is something that I, as a user, have to define. So when I create in flow conditions mode, on top of the borehole water levels that I already have, additional water levels, those will automatically get the name user water level. So they're both water levels. They work the same from engineering point of view. They just have different names so that you as a user know the origin of a water level. If you have a whole list of water levels, you know that the borehole water levels are the ones that Plexus generated. The user water levels are the ones that you put in yourself. You could, by the way, always give a different name to a water level. If you want to assign a user water level the name phreatic level after excavation to -2 meters, you can do so. You can change the name and give it a name that it makes more sense to you for this specific project. Now, on top of that, and that is more based on functionality, one of those water levels has to be what we call the global water level. Why do we need a global water level? Well, as you can imagine, we don't want to particularly assign for every little bit of soil in our model what water level is going to be used there. So what Plexus does is says, well, if you don't explicitly assign a water level to a certain soil area, then we just give it some default level, and that default is the global water level. And in principle, this global water level initially is based on the head value of your borehole. So if you fill in a head value of plus 5 meters, then Plexus will create a water level at plus 5 meters, and it will make it the global water level. And any soil that you don't explicitly say what water level is going to be applied in that soil will then become the get the global water level. You can, during the calculation, change the global water level to another level. So you can now say that another water level from this moment on has to be the global level. That can be a borehole water level. It can be a user water level. The whole idea about a global water level is to have at least a default water level in case you didn't tell Plexus what water level is going to be applied there. Now, how can we assign that? There are a couple of options. If you have in water conditions mode, in this case it's a big dam construction, you can select a certain area. It will become red. Then you can either in the selection explorer from the part that you just selected, go to the water conditions option in the selection explorer, and then click on the drop-down box, and then you have a couple of options. You can also, in the graphical representation, right-click on that red area, and then you get a list of possibilities. But then you can say whether a certain area, a certain soil area, has either the global level, which is already the default, but you could change it to another level and later decide that you want to put it back. You can give it a custom level, in which case you have to pick which other water level of the defined water levels you want to assign. You can just specify it as a head value. So you can say, well, I don't want to pick a water level. This has a head of plus 10 meters, and then you can do so. You can make a user-defined distribution, in which case you have to give at a certain reference level what is the pore pressure and then an increment per depth. You could use that if you want the increment to be more than the water weight. So instead of an increment of 10 kilopascal per meter depth, you want to have 12 or 14, or maybe even want to decrease it with depth, and sometimes in clay layers that is also possible. We have the option to interpolate. So what an interpolate option does is that it takes the water, the pore pressure, directly above the layer and directly below, and it just does a linear interpolation of pore pressures over the height of the layer where you assign the property interpolate. And for instance, you have a clay layer in between two sand layers. The two sand layers have different heads. The clay layer we set to interpolate, so the clay layer just checks in the sand layer in the limit with the sand layer above what is the pore pressure on that border. It does the same directly below. It takes those two pore pressures and just does a linear interpolation over the height of my clay layer to interpolate the pore pressures. And the last option is to set it dry. And well, as the name already says, if you set it dry, then your soil has no pore pressures, it will be perfectly dry. This can be used very fast, for instance, in an excavation to just say that a certain area should be completely dry. No soil, no water. So we said that it's dry. And as I said, you can do that from the selection explorer, or you can just right click with the mouse on the area where you want to make the change. Now, this is only part one of defining my calculation construction. Part two is the construction, the stage construction mode, where we can do basically anything else that is not related to water flow and thermal flow. Well, first of all, what we have to do is that we have to... yes?
Sorry to break. We got a lot of requests from people that want to have like a 5-minute break. They're really desperate to go to the toilet. If we do a quick break here,
yeah, sure.
So we can continue.